Let's all go to the lobby. Yeah, what's up YouTube? It's Jose with Cinema of the Dead. Quick little video here I did of I'm doing of a bust I just bought from Little Corpse Magnets on Etsy. I'm a big fan of Interview with the Vampire. It's a vampire movie that stars Brad Pitt, Christian Slater, and Tom Cruise. And you know, Tom Cruise and Brad Pitt are some of my favorite, you know, actors, especially back in the day. And this movie, man, I used to always watch this movie. I have so many memories of watching this movie, man. I love it. And I don't hear too many people, you know, mention it. I'm not sure if they're embarrassed about it or something. And I don't really care, man. I love this movie. It's badass movie, man. If you guys seen it, let me know in the comments if you guys enjoy it or if it's a guilty pleasure of yours. Mine, I love this movie. But I found this is the first bust I've ever seen of it. So when I saw it, I was like, man, I gotta have it. And it's the version of this is a Tom Cruise one where he comes back after the little girl and, you know, kills him, and he comes back, you know, all decomposing, and man, that scene is badass. But all right guys, here he is. So this is the artist's his vision of Lestat. And he made him a little bit more zombie-like, I guess, more corpse-like. I just thought that was badass, man. Like in person, it looks just like Tom Cruise, man, when he comes back in that scene. I remember when I was young, when I went to go see Interview with the Vampire at the movies. I was a little youngster, and I remember that scene. I was like, man, he creeped me the fuck out. Tom would always creep me the fuck out in that scene. But yeah, guys, there he is, Lestat from Interview with a Vampire. When he comes back and he's playing the piano, he's all pissed off because, the little girl killed him, basically, you know what I mean? Well, she did kill him, and they threw him in the bayou, and they thought the alligators and the crocodiles ate him or whatever. But yeah, it's right there. It's the rotting corpse vampire, Lestat. He has a lot of scenes. I also bought a top hat for him because I don't know if you guys remember in the movies, if you guys are a fan, he wears a top hat for a lot of the scenes before he's like decomposing, when he's just a vampire, where they look all beautiful, you know, they're like flawless. There he is. That's Lestat, Louis, and Antonio Banderas. But yeah, he always has a top hat on, so I bought a top hat, see what he would look like with it. And I think I'm going to display him with the top hat. He looks really badass with it on. It just reminds me more of gives him more of that Interview with a Vampire vibe. There he is. I know if you guys remember that scene towards the end of the movie where Brad Pitt goes back to New Orleans and he's walking, he says, I caught the stench of air, dead. Of death in the air, but it was old death, not new death, or something like that. And he goes into that old ass creepy house, and he's in there looking all decomposed and creepy as fuck. I'm gonna give you the choice I never had. That's what Tom Cruise always tells his victims, that he wants to turn into a vampire.
I'm going to give you the choice.
But you know what, now that I'm older and I do watch, you know, Interview with a Vampire, I do get, I guess it's not very underlining, you know, I do get the, you know, the gay references, and, you know, you could tell that Lestat was in love with Louis. Well, if you read the author's interviews, if you watch her interviews and stuff, she says that Lestat was supposed to be in love with Louis with Brad Pitt. I mean, it's in there, you know, they never have a love interest, and they're, you know, raising that little girl together. So, I mean, it's not even underlined. I mean, it's all there, kind of like the Nightmare on Elm Street Part 2. you know, with the homosexual undertones or whatever. But yeah, man, this movie, I love this movie, man. Such a badass movie. I don't understand why people are embarrassed to say they like it, or I don't know, I'm not sure, but man, it's like a really good movie to me. If you guys haven't seen it in a while and you guys think you guys don't like it, you guys should give it another shot, watch it again. I have a feeling you guys will like it. I don't know, maybe it's just me. But man, I always wanted to have something from Interview with a Vampire. And in person, when you're looking at it, man, I totally see Tom Cruise's face when I'm staring at it from across the room. Totally looks like a zombie, vampire Tom Cruise.
Claudia, you've been a very, very...
Yeah, I'll put a picture up right here of when he's wearing a top hat. But I think he only wears a top hat when he's, you know, like all pretty and still not decomposed. I'm gonna get a plaque right here. It says Interview with a Vampire. Just think the plaques just give it that little extra, I don't know, quality look to the bust, you know what I mean? And for the name tags, I just go to a name tags place online. I think it's called nametags.com. And I just get them like this because I like these. I don't know, I just feel like they look better, like this Gremlin one I have and an Annabelle one I have. I just want to get them all so they all look the same. Try to get some close-ups of him, guys. See if you could get his little fangs, his little vampire teeth. But yeah, I got him the Etsy shop I got him from. It's Little Corpses Magnets on Etsy. He has a bunch of other horror items on there too. He makes mostly little those chunky magnets. Pretty badass. I want to get a couple of those to put on my fridge right here. He makes some badass magnets, horror magnets. And he also has some other busts. He actually makes a life-size leprechaun as well. I already have my leprechaun, but his leprechaun looks pretty cool. Turn him around. I guess we get a little back view of him.
Claudia, you've been a very, very naughty little girl.
Oh, Louis. He's open to it. Still whining, Louis.
To the men that follow.
Have you heard enough?
But it was
I've had to listen to that for centuries.
I always like period pieces, you know, period movies. And this one's just always been a favorite of mine, man. I guess because of the horror elements in it. Also, you know, because it's based in New Orleans and it has that, I don't know why, man, to me it gives me that like Haunted Mansion vibe. And then he has a top hat, like the top hat ghost. I don't know, man, always just gives me that Haunted Mansion vibe with them as well. But I don't know, do you guys consider Interview with a Vampire, is that like a chick flick? Do you guys consider it? I you know what, honestly, I'm not sure. I never have. I could see why people would consider it that, but I mean, man, I love that movie. Man, this the vibe it gives me, and just I always wanted something from there, but I never thought anybody would bust of it. And actually, this one, I don't know if you guys noticed in the video, the clip I put on there, he didn't look this decomposed. It's just his perception of it. He made him like a little bit more decomposed. Well, I guess he does. You know what? The ending scene, the last time Brad Pitt sees him, when he's in that abandoned all creepy looking mansion. He kind of does look like this, but it's too dark. You can't really see him too much. All right, guys, well, that's about it. You know, please hit that like button, show that love. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so. And I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching the video. Oh yeah, and by the way, don't you think Kristen Dunst, it's like her best performance? She was like a little girl. She did a badass performance in this movie as well.
Claudia.